In this video, we are going to take a look at how we can add multiple social media feed in our WordPress website. So if you want to promote your social media profiles and want to showcase your work from social media on your WordPress website, then this video is for you. So let me first show you how it looks. So in order to add this multiple social media feed, we are going to use the plus add-ons for Gutenberg, and there we have a social feed block. And using this, we will be able to create a multiple feed wall, which will look something like this. So here we can see posts from various social media profiles, and above this, we have a filter option. So if you want to see only Twitter feeds, we can click here. And if you want to see only YouTube, then here is an option. And if you want to only see from Facebook, then click on Facebook. And in the same way, we can select Instagram to see only Instagram posts. So this is how we can create this multi-social feed wall. And we can also use different styles and layouts. So if we scroll down a little bit, we can customize our filters like this one, or maybe like this one. Or maybe we can have this whole menu like this. So if that sounds interesting and you also want to create this multiple social media feed wall on your WordPress website, then hop in and I'll show you everything step by step. My name is Ankit Sharma from the team POSIMYTH, and if you want to deep dive in the world of Gutenberg, then make sure you subscribe to this channel and hit the notification bell so that you can get notified whenever we upload our next video. So let's dive in our WordPress backend and see how all this works. Are in our WordPress backend, and if we go in the plugin section, here we have the plus add-ons for block editor free as well as the pro version. And once both of these plugins are installed, we can now go to plus settings and then click on plus blocks. And here we are going to search for social feed, and this is the social feed block that we are going to use. And as you can see, it's part of the pro plan of this plugin, so make sure you have the pro plan installed and activated. And after that, just make sure you turn on this block and then click on save. So now we have activated our block. Let's go ahead and add this in a page and see how this works. So we go to pages and then click on add new, and let's call it multi-feed wall. And here let's start by adding a single row. So we will choose TP row block, and we will choose a single column layout. And under this, we are going to add our social feed block. And now we just need to connect our different social media profiles, and here we will get all the social media feed. So for that, on the settings, here we have the content feed, and under this we have the content type. So right now it is set on Facebook. If we click here, we have an option for Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, YouTube, Vimeo. So we can get posts and feeds from all these social media platforms and show all of that in this single page. And in order to get feed from all of these platforms, we need to get access to some API keys and passwords. So if in case we select Facebook and we select a Facebook page and use token generator, so here we need the access token as well as the page ID. And it is same for all the other platforms. For Instagram, we again need an access token and page ID. And for Twitter, we need various other API keys and passwords. And in the same way, we need to get the access token for YouTube as well as for Vimeo. Now we have created a separate video for all these social media websites, how you can get these access token and API keys and then show the social feed on your site. So you can go ahead and watch our complete playlist. We will link that in the I button above. So right now we will just copy paste all the API keys and passwords here so that we can quickly create our feed wall. So right now we choose Facebook and we will select page instead of individual. And we have already generated the access token, so we will just copy paste it here. So here is our access token and here is our page ID. So as soon as we enter the page ID, we can see that our feed is showing here. Now in order to create this feed wall, we need to give this a category name. So let's say we call it Facebook, and now let's close this. And now we will add one more social feed, and this time we will choose Instagram. Again, we will choose business, and instead of manual, we will use token generator. And again, we already have all this detail, so we will just paste it here. So here goes the access token and the page ID. And now you see we have the Instagram as well. And for this one, let's go ahead and type in our username. And for the category, let's call it Instagram. Alright, so let's close this one. And then we will add another social feed. And for this one, we will select YouTube. Once again, we will add the access token. And for the channel, we will paste the channel ID. And for the category, we will call it YouTube. In the same way, let's add another one. And this time, we will choose Twitter. So let's fill up all these details. So as soon as we enter all these details, we can see our Twitter feed loading here. So here in the user feed, we will type in username as POSIMYTH and let's choose show media. And for the category, we will type in Twitter. So let's close this one as well. So now we have added all the social media feed as we need, but this does not look like a feed wall. So for that, we need to go to filters and then choose the category wise filter. So let's turn this on. So now we have this tab structure which we can use to filter our posts. So let's publish this page here and see how it looks in the front end. So here we have all feeds showing with 22 posts. And if we click on Facebook, we can see only Facebook feed. If we click on Instagram, here is only Instagram. And if we click on YouTube, here are our YouTube videos. And if we click on Twitter, we can only see the Twitter feed. Now if we come back here, and here are various options that we can play around with. And once again, we have already covered all of that separately for all these social media platforms. So here we can go to styles, and here we have two options, universal styling as well as individual social media styling. So here for universal, we can set the uniform typography. So let's say for title, we want it to be 13 pixel. And for the description, we want 12 pixel. So it will shrink down the text for all the feed. So we can use this individual styling to give a uniform styling to all these social media feeds. But the best part here is that we can individually style all of these social media feed. So let's say for Facebook, we go to background and let's add a light blue shade. In the same way for YouTube, let's go ahead and add a background color which will be a light red, something like this. And for the Twitter, again we will choose a different shade of blue. And for Instagram, let's add a purple shade. So we will choose this color from here. As you can see, we already have different background color for different social media accounts. So if we update this page here and let's refresh our front end. So now we see we have a multicolor social media feed. So for Facebook, we have this blue color feed. For Instagram, we have this purple shade. For YouTube, we have this light red shade. And for Twitter, we have this blue shade again. So this is how we can add a unique and different style to all of these social media feed. And once again, if you want to learn more about each social media feed, how you can generate the access token and API keys, you can watch our complete playlist. You can watch our complete playlist where we covered all of these platforms separately. So this is how easy it is to create a social media feed wall using the plus add-ons for Gutenberg. If you like this video, then make sure you hit the like button, and if you want to watch more videos like this and learn how you can do some amazing stuff with the plus add-ons for Gutenberg, then make sure you subscribe to this channel and hit the notification bell so that you can get notified whenever we upload our next video. So that's it for this one, and I'll see you in the next video.